friend's tree. The boy's waiting for the great hunter to return. And so he does, sack in hand. What things has he bagged tonight?
Yeah. Gotcha. Stop wriggling, you little worm. Come in, Missy. Ouch, that hurt.
Ha ha.
Happy night. I'll go and check on those macaroons. Splash, that is not right.
Walk on me, Toro. What's up? Darling house. Nana has been allowed back into the house by a Mr. Darling who feels very guilty.
If only I had thrown you out that night, Nana, you might have stopped Peter Pan tempting our children away to Neverland. If only I'd known about him and his shadow. But for now, it is I who must live in the kennel. Sign of my regrets. Gosh, that's really good news. I just can't do things like Aunt Mary. You know that. And the kennel will be until they come home. Let's leave the window open, as always, and try and get some sleep. Look, they're in here, and it looks like they've been waiting for us.
Oh my goodness, is that Father in the kennel?
I think we've come back just in time.
It's been fun meeting a real fairy, Tinkerbell. Look after Peter, won't you?
I will. Here, have this.
Fairy dust, thank you. I thought I heard Wendy's voice.
It must have been a dream.
Mother, we're home! George, Nana, they're home! They're really home! At last, our little family are back together.
Oh, Wendy, what about the lost boys?
Oh my goodness, I almost forgot!
Lost boys? What lost boys?
Never mind, Father. We said they can come and live with us.
You don't mind, do you? There's only 5 of them.
What do you think, Nana?
Let's invite them in.
And so, all in the moment, the Darling household practically doubled, and the nursery is once again filled with dragons and castles and all the wonderful stuff of imagination.
Peter! Peter Pan! Aren't you staying, Peter?
Would you maybe go to school and then work in an office?
Yes, Peter. It's all part of growing up.
Then I'll go back to Neverland, thank you.
Do you think you'll ever go back, Wendy?
I'm not sure, Mother. But something of the Neverland will always be with me. Now I've learned to fly. I'm sure I'll never forget how.
Oops. Sorry, Nana.
Can I have that kennel back now?
Nana!
much for coming this evening. It really has been an absolute treat and a journey. My goodness, it started all the way back in January, would you believe it? And we've had to overcome COVID outbreaks and all sorts of things. And I know people say, oh, we don't want to talk about COVID anymore, but my goodness, it really impacted this the rehearsal period, isn't it, children? And it was just so uncertain at times, but I tell you what, your children are absolutely magnificent. They stepped up to the challenge. They all pretty much know each other's lines, which is just phenomenal. And we've had, this afternoon, had a couple of instances, people not well, people getting injured and things, and they're just ready and hungry to take it on. And I'm just so proud of them. I hope that you share that from sitting. And I know some of you have seen it a few times, but I just can't express that enough. So children, really from the bottom of my heart, I'm so proud of you. I know you've seen a dragon side of me as well. that's just the fine balance side. But they know I mean well. They know I have high expectations of them. And it's really a credit you listening to me, Mr. Vine, Miss Harlock, Miss Knight, who are the teachers helping in the wings and just being really honest. So really, really well done for that. And thank you for giving us your children.
Thank you.
She has, the highest of expectations for the children. I think they've really enjoyed having her come and direct everything and really, really make sure that each tiny element is as perfect as it can be. And where would you be without you, Rebecca Knight? Lessons tomorrow. But other than that, we will bring the children out to you.